Small island developing states matter. They've got extraordinary biodiversity and natural resources that support our planet, and they're extremely resilient, and we have a lot to learn from their resilience. About 65 million people live on over 1,000 islands that make up these small island developing states. And those 65 million people are part of our community, they're part of our planet. If we do nothing, that is a death sentence. And right now, with climate change, these island nations are at risk. And they now need our help. I was lucky enough to grow up on the west coast of Ireland and spent all of my time exploring tide pools and in the ocean. And it drove me to be a scientist, but also to recognize the importance of the ocean in our lives. And that gets me up every morning. I am Dr. Deborah Brosnan. I'm a marine scientist and climate risk expert. I work around the world looking at ways that nature-based solutions can help us adapt to climate change and create resilience and also help communities. Small island developing states are a group of island nations around the world. There are places like Antigua and Barbuda, Barbados, St. Lucia, the Maldives. They create about less than 1% of greenhouse gas emissions, yet they suffer disproportionately. And the reason for that is that they are vulnerable to sea level rise, to increases in natural disasters, and they're vulnerable to having increased debt, which makes it harder for them to grow and develop sustainably. Small island developing states also have a huge amounts of biodiversity that's important to us, all of us. Their oceans help to regulate climate. They have coral reefs that sustain 12% of the world's fisheries. Very important for us. A lot of these island nations are torn or between the cycle of recovering from natural disasters, which costs a lot, and then trying to invest in growth. So we have to look at how do we make that debt more sustainable, and how do we support them to become more resilient so we can break that cycle. And nature-based solutions are one of the ways we can do it. Nature-based solutions is using the services that nature provides us for free, and it's leveraging those services in order to make ourselves more resilient. Those natural resources that surround the small island developing states are the first line of defense against hurricanes, against storms, against flooding. We need to make sure that they are in good condition, and for many of them it means restoration. Coral reefs are probably one of the best examples of nature-based solutions. They are one of the original technologies that communities around the world have been using for eons. A healthy coral reef breaks 95% of a wave's energy. They protect our homes, they protect our businesses and our hotels from storm surge and from sea level rise. They provide jobs and they provide tourism. They support 25% of marine biodiversity, 12% of the world's fisheries, and yet only 4% of the planet is made up of coral reefs. Where we're taking the idea of coral reefs to the next phase is really interesting, and it's something that I am very passionate about and love, which is the idea of ocean shot, which is in areas where there are no reefs or where the reefs have collapsed because we've lost about a third of coral reefs. How do we bring that ecosystem service, that habitat creation, that coastal protection back? So what we're doing is we're doing the science to learn what is the structure of a reef? How is it shaped in order to break wave energy? How is it shaped in order to provide habitat for fish, for octopus, for lobster? And then mimicking that shape, building it and putting it in the ocean in areas where we know it can have an effect to protect the shoreline, to create resilience and to create habitat and fisheries. I'll give you another example. Mangroves sequester 4 times more carbon than even tropical rainforests, but they do more than that. So they support fisheries. They are great at filtering water and keeping water clear and clean. They're fantastic for flood control. They form a great buffer between the land and the sea. So taken together, these nature-based solutions for mangroves are phenomenal. And then the management of these mangroves, the restoration of mangroves, provides new kinds of jobs in these communities. Nature-based solutions were the original technology. We're just now beginning to realize it and use it. without finance, nothing's going to happen. That's the truth. The private sector should get involved because investing in small island nations, particularly in hospitality or in sustaining nature, provides a return on investment. Hotels, resorts rely on gorgeous nature for their guests to enjoy, and the old way was to cut down everything and then to try and landscape it back to what looked like a normal natural area. When the hospitality industry approaches a development and goes, what is there already? What nature, what landscape is there, and what services is it providing to us that we can leverage and enhance? That changes the whole equation. The hospitality industry has a unique opportunity to create nature-based solutions, to align with nature and natural processes, to create resilience and sustainability, to help the islands through the transition of climate change, while at the same time being economically viable, getting return on investment, and creating new types of jobs, which for the private sector makes a great deal of sense. Collaboration is essential. None of us can do this on our own. We need the government and we need the hospitality industry working very closely together. And then bringing in the community is key as well. If we get all of those in the same room and taking action, I'm so hopeful about where we'll end up. If we do nothing, we are turning our back on 65 million people. If we do nothing, the outcome is dire. If we do something, we have a real opportunity. Thank you.